Have you ever seen something move out of the corner of your eye? Ever heard something whispering from the walls? Hear footsteps down the hallway when you were home alone? Well, what if I told you your house isn't haunted? It's just moldy. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Fungi, like mushrooms and molds, might be some of my favorite kinds of organisms on this planet, but these special eukaryotes can do some serious damage. I mean, more than just making your toenails disgusting. Sometimes they can make people go a little bananas. So you're home alone and it's 1 in the morning and you hear footsteps creeping down the hall. Is it a ghost? Maybe the scientific explanation isn't ectoplasm, maybe it's just fungus. I mean, there's been more than a few cases throughout history where fungus caused a paranormal calamity. Like one of the most famous and one of my favorite stories from history. Once upon a time, in a little town called Salem, people started to get scared, very scared. The young girls in the village were acting a little strange. They had seizures, visions, and so the most logical thing at the time was to start pointing fingers at witches. After all was said and done, more than 200 people were accused and 20 were put to death. And some researchers think it was all because of a little fungus, specifically the species claviceps purpurea, or as it's commonly called, ergot. Ergot's a nifty little fungus that grows on rye, a wheat-like cereal grain, when conditions are cold and damp. It's so nifty, it might be possibly hallucinogenic. It's the source of lysergic acid, the thing LSD is based off of. Ergot contains certain alkaloids that can react with serotonin receptors in the brain, producing those hallucinogenic effects LSD is so famous for. But besides the fun effects, ergot rot on wheat plants can get pretty nasty. Its two main types of symptoms are gangrenous or convulsive. Gangrenous is popularly called St. Anthony's fire, so named because of the effects on people's limbs. It makes them swell and feel like they're burning and causing blisters on the skin. Eventually, the limb can die and fall off at the joints. Seriously, not a pretty sight. Convulsive ergotism is the belle of our ball here, or Salem's ball. If ingested, its poison can cause hallucinations and convulsions, very similar symptoms to what the girls in Salem experienced. The idea was first put forward in the journal Science in 1976 by psychologist Linda Corporal. She noticed that the girls' symptoms closely matched those of ergotism. In another analysis, historian Dr. Mary K. Matossian came to the same conclusion. She told the New York Times that the Salem witch trials may have been part of a largely unrecognized American health problem. Even 40 years later, it's still the best explanation we've got for what occurred all those years ago. So knowing about ergot poisoning could explain a lot of the unexplained still happening in some parts of the world. Perhaps it's just a fungus growing in your home. Researchers from Clarkson University are hitting the houses. They believe there might be a link between old houses and hauntings. Not because somebody died in there and their ghost is hanging out, but they're investigating the possibility that poor air ventilation and a few decades of mold growth might make things go bump in the night. Well, they'll make you think they are. Similar to how ergot affected the girls in Salem, some other toxic molds commonly found in the house can cause similar symptoms. Lead researcher Dr. Shane Rogers, associate professor of civil and environmental engineering, told DNews that reported mental and physical health symptoms and experiences of those exposed to poor air quality, including molds, and experiences including physical and mental reported in hauntings are strikingly similar. And he even mentioned that there have been other cases where toxic mold in homes drove people mad. He mentioned a case where a mass murderer claimed God told him to do it. But upon investigation of his home, they found high levels of lysergic acid, which the investigators concluded were contributing factors to his horrific acts. As for Dr. Rogers' current research, well, they've been pretty varied and interesting, with more than a few tense moments, anxious feelings, or odd happenings that they could not find easy answers to. Because of mold? Well, more research is needed. So have you ever experienced something unexplained? Maybe you knew something you couldn't have known. Did you ever wonder if it's ESP? Are you actually picking up on something paranormal? Are you picking up on something else altogether? Anthony and Lacey have the spooky scoop in this episode right here.
ESP is, in a nutshell, knowing something that isn't immediately obvious. For instance, you're sitting next to a dude on a train and you sense that he's been in a car accident.
Or that he murdered someone.
Right, or murder detection, which is a very useful ESP skill.
So what do you think, hauntings or mold problem? Have you experienced a haunting? Please tell us about it in the comments below. I really want to hear your stories. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you get all the DNews episodes.